good singer and a damn good person.
Did she just hit that note?
She was sexy. She was sassy.
She is so incredibly talented.
Whenever I hear her music, it's really comforting to me.
It's like mother's milk. That's the one thing that
daddy made sure of. Probably the best pipes ever.
I hate that woman.
Passionate, feminine, tender and nurturing, confident, innovative, strong and determined. It's all of these qualities that make up the lives and the music of the CMT 40 Greatest Women of Country. I'm Billy Campbell and we're finally at the top 10. We polled singers, songwriters, critics and music industry insiders all over America and we got their votes for the women whose contributions helped define country music. But before we look at our top 10, let's take a look back at the artists who have brought us this far. Very few new artists have made quite the impact as this great lady of country. In 1991, she became the first woman in almost three decades to see her debut single reach number one on the country charts. The song was about the remembrance of love and the joy it can bring. And since then, she's taken the country ballad to places it's never been. At number 10, vocal powerhouse Trisha Yearwood. Her daddy says he ain't worth a lick. When it
comes to brains, he got the short end of the stick. There's a power and passion to Trisha Yearwood's voice that leaves a distinct impression. She'd follow Tommy
anywhere. She's in love. When I think about Trisha Yearwood singing, sitting next to her, I kept thinking, dang, sounds like a record. She doesn't have any bad notes. Everybody knows what to do about my
misery. Everybody but me. You just go, okay, my life is over. I've heard the perfect artist singing the perfect song. That is the magic that Trisha brings to a record. On a bus to St. Cloud, Minnesota, I thought I saw.
She just delivers it, her voice, as if it were a gift to us.
Snow falling down around it like a silent prayer.
Trisha is one of those rare singers that you just, you love the sound of her voice, regardless of what she sings.
With her intelligent approach to songs, showed again that women could be a force in country music. That boy's just a walk away, born to be a
lover, tell you from the word, destined to deceive. The raw emotion of Trisha's vocals have drawn an impressive list of duet partners, from Garth Brooks and Aaron Neville to Don Henley. That boy was a
walk away. When I heard her sing, I was just struck. She really knows how to pick material. All I can say about Trisha is she's just a damn good singer and a damn good person.
She's opened up. She's taken chances. She's exposing herself. She's trying things now on stage, and you can see it blossom, and I think it looks beautiful.
Throughout her career, there hasn't been a year that Trisha's magic hasn't been felt on the country charts.
One of her strengths would be musical consistency. Every song she does is really good. There's just very few that reach the standard set by Trisha Yearwood. And I love you that way.
I've been interested to watch in the past 10 years. We always talk about Patsy Cline and Connie Smith and Loretta Lynn, people of that magnitude, Tammy Wynette. But it's interesting to see as time goes on, the ones that really do line up and belong in that the same category. Trisha Yearwood goes there. She's sung her way into our hearts. She belongs there. She's going to stay forever. This real
woman. 1 minute, she was an Ohio housewife who'd reluctantly agreed to enter a talent contest. And a year later, her first single was at the top of the country charts. At number 9, it's Connie Smith.
She appeared out of nowhere in 1964 to spend 8 weeks at the top of the country charts with her debut single, Once a Day.
It's once a day, every day, all day long.
Her voice hit the airwaves soaked with deep down emotion, and the listeners could relate to every word.
Connie Smith's voice is a pillar of fire.
She's so tiny with this enormous booming voice that sounds like she's speaking directly to God, which she probably is.
Then slowly lost her mind. She sat around.
You're just standing in a room with no microphones. She'll knock you over with her voice. She's just that strong and that powerful.
One more hour and I'll be home.
With Connie Smith, it's not just the voice, but how she uses it. She's one of the great vocal stylists who is in complete command of every sound that comes out of her mouth.
Cincinnati, Ohio.
The way she always used to do that little yep thing, you know, the way she held her notes and all, I thought she was such a stylist.
Where is my castle?
It makes her sound desperate and urgent and vulnerable and forlorn. You know, all of those great things that a country singer should be, she's got it.
To me, Connie Smith should be just as big as any girl singer in this business today.
Where is my valley?
But at the height of her fame, Connie made a conscious choice not to pursue superstardom. Just like the subject she sang about in her songs, she longed for love and family.
The sky was the limit for anybody that could sing that way. I had the looks and the presence, but the thing that meant the most to her was her family.
If I could see you just one time.
She is just as happy cooking a good meal as she is making a good record.
Though her career was brief, Connie Smith still holds the heart of country music, and of one man in particular.
When I was a little boy, my mama's favorite singer was Connie Smith. We had this record called Miss Smith Goes to Nashville. And I studied it and I looked at her face. I loved her. I thought she was an angel. She came to my hometown and played when I was 12 years old. On the way home, I said, Mom, I'm going to marry her. 25 years later, I did. It's the greatest thing I've ever done in my life.
Coming up, the mother of country music and the superstar who took country music to places never imagined. When CMT 40 Greatest Women of Country Music continues.